Hi guys, about 2 months ago I uploaded a video where I walked you through the first 4 months of my hair transplant journey, and the response has been overwhelming. The video has passed 100,000 views and have gotten around 300 comments, and I've also been flooded with messages on Instagram. You've had a lot of questions, so I'll try my best to answer them as good as I can in this video. I'm about a week away from the 6 month mark, and I'm scheduled for a new haircut in a couple of days. So by the end of this video, I'll also include some footage of the new haircut and give you a 6 month update. But now let's dive into the questions. How old are you? I turned 30 in about 1 month, on the 11th of January. Did you go to Turkey for your hair transplant? No, I did not. I did the procedure with a clinic here in Sweden, in Stockholm. What's the name of your clinic? Acacia Medical. How many grafts? I did 3,500 grafts. Do you like your new hairline? I love it. I really, really love it. What made you go for a hair transplant rather than shaving your head? Well, to be honest, I was 100% sure that the shaved look was not for me. I really thought that I would have some strange looking head underneath the hair that I had. But ironically, I had to shave my head for the surgery, and afterwards I kind of not hated it. I can't say I loved it, but it wasn't too bad. So if I go bald anyway later in life, then now I know that I can maybe rock the shaved look. How did you go about washing your hair after 1 month? Well, regular showers, but with the shampoo that I got from the clinic. And then I just let the hair, what you call it, air dry. So no towel. I don't know if I was extra careful maybe, but I didn't dry my hair with a towel for maybe 2 months. That's the perks of doing the transplant in the summertime, because it's really hot. And also for the first 2 months I barely had any hair at all, so it wasn't too hard to air dry. Have you started using any hair styling products in your hair yet? No, I have not. Because I haven't had the need for it. I like to have my hair sort of up, and it has been like that without any help of products. So I've just gone with it. Why didn't you get a hair transplant in the middle area? I'm guessing you are referring to the crown. Well, I went on a consultation with one clinic who said that they only wanted to do the front, and I was not too happy about that because I really wanted to do something about this area as well. So I went to a different clinic and they said that they would focus on the front and then do whatever is left and put it up here as well. And that was more the response that I was hoping for. So I had a little bit done up here, but I will probably need another surgery in a couple of years. But that's fine. How much did it cost? Well, here in Sweden it costs $6,000. US dollars, or 60,000 Swedish crowns. I don't know where you're from, but everyone knows how much a dollar is worth, so. When can you start drinking alcohol and start smoking again? Well, I drank alcohol about 2 weeks after for the first time. And I actually quit smoking before the procedure because my clinic said that they don't operate on smokers. But then when the procedure was done, who knows what I did? Okay, I'll be honest with you. I may have started smoking 6 weeks after the procedure again. And I haven't been able to quit since then, but I will. I know it's terrible for your hair growth and your health, of course, and your wallet. Don't smoke. Was it painful, the hair transplant? Well, not too painful. I had, what you call it? Bedövning, engelska, anesthesia. I had anesthesia. The anesthesia itself was a bit painful or unpleasant, but the surgery was not. Have you done any PRP treatments and how often? I had one PRP treatment on the day of the surgery afterwards, and then I had another one about 2 months after. And then I've had my third PRP treatment just about a week ago, which was like 5.5 months after. I should have gone more often, but I've been slacking. Now for the most frequently asked question or questions. Are you on minoxidil or finasteride? No, I am not, and I haven't been at all. It's not something I've been told to be on. So that's why. And to be honest, I haven't given it too much research either. So I don't know what to say. Just no. Maybe I should, maybe I shouldn't. I know there are some side effects, but it's not something I'm scared of. So I might get on those medications later. I'll just do some research first and then decide. So those were your questions. Now if you stick around for the rest of this video, you'll get to see my new haircut and a 6 month update. Alright, so I've had my haircut done a few days ago and I decided to go for a skin fade. Last time I had a skin fade was 1 month before the hair transplant. Back then I looked like this. Jag kan nästan få lite dåligt samvete att min frisör Asaf lagt så mycket tid och kärlek på att få det här någorlunda snyggt. Och så ska allt bara rakas av om några veckor. This was my second haircut since my surgery, but it was the first time they cut my new transplanted hair, which was a strange but great feeling. I haven't been able to check out my donor area yet, but I will do that as I publish this video. That's also why I wanted to go for a skin fade, to really be able to see my neck and the donor area. Let me know what you think, and if you have any other questions, then leave them in the comments and I'll try to answer them. Take care.